Hello and welcome, I'm Rupert Cooper and this is the Rupert Cooper Show, and today is a special day because we are celebrating the new year, and I am in fact here at the Winky Willy's fish and chip shop in Scarborough just to celebrate. Now I know that's a bit funny, but it's not that funny. It's quite funny, but anyways, before we get started with
here's this. Recording from Scarborough Beach as a special for the Happy New Year. This is the Rupert Cooper Show with me, Rupert Cooper.
Hello, right, I am here. So, good thing about the Winking Willy is that it is that good that the queue is very, very long. We have just waited for about 45 minutes just to get in, which I would say is a good sign, which would say that the food is good. It may also say that some other restaurants may not be open. Anyways, the menu is quite good here at the Winking Willy's. Sorry, I can't stop laughing about that. Right, here's the menu about it, and I will go through it with you. Now, the menu is quite good. I have actually ordered myself a sausage and chips, because that is my personal favourite. I like it with mushy peas and curry sauce. Obviously not mixed together, but anyway, that would be quite weird. So I'll go through what I've done today. I have actually been to see some people run in the sea in funny costumes. Now, it must have been very cold, because, it must have been very, very cold, because it's freezing outside anyway. So, in the comments below, right, would you go into the sea wearing a funny costume if it was really freezing like that? And some stayed in for like half an hour. It was quite good. Sorry if there's some talking in the background. I am in a restaurant filming, so there might be a lot of talking. Anyways, so after that, I got donuts, sugared donuts. They are very nice. And a hot chocolate, actually, because it was so cold, I needed something to warm me up. Now, there wasn't much else after that. Oh, yes, I went to an arcade. And didn't win anything else, really.
Well, what do you think about the time?
Didn't win much, anyway.
Right. I didn't even know it was on.
Next on the show, we are going to go through the goods and bads about Scarborough, some good facts about Scarborough,
and
in the comments below, write down whether you've been to Scarborough before or are here for New Year's in the same way that I am for the people running into the sea.
100.
Now, I would just like to let you know that if anybody wanted my intros, I don't know why, they are now going to be on shorts on my YouTube channel.
But it has to be my room's electricity, though.
Here is my intro phone.
No, because you guys use electricity. It's Rupert.
Fun facts here on the Rupert Cooper Show. Welcome back to the Rupert Cooper Show. I have travelled all the way back to RTV Studios just to give you the rest of my show. So, five interesting facts about Scarborough. So, the first fact, Scarborough is blessed with two sandy bays in the blue flagged North Beach and South Bay. And then the second fact, in 1829, Anne Bronte died and was buried in Scarborough. Now, I'm not sure who Anne Bronte is. Should we search that up? Oh, she was an English novelist and poet, and she was buried in Scarborough. The third one, there are blue plaques around the town. Sorry. There are blue plaques around the town, including one celebrating Anne Bronte, Wilfred Owen, and the poet and birthplace of Charles Lawton, the actor amongst others. Now that's quite interesting because it shows the famous people, or old famous people, some would like to say, that were there, that lived there and were buried there. And I would just like to show you my, sorry if you hear a few clicking, my Rupert Cooper Show thing. This was meant for Christmas and I was meant to do all the weather and stuff, but I just wasn't really well. And to be honest, I didn't feel very well. And anyways, after that, sorry my TV looks a bit diagonal to you on the photos. Anyways, right, back onto our Scarborough facts. It surprised me that the Conservative Club host regular bingo session due to Shout Government instead of House where there was a winner. The spa has also been refurbished at a cost of £6.5 million and reopened in May 2011 with performance by Bolshoi Symphony Orchestra. Then our last one is, kids are well catered for. There are numerous amusements, rock stores and fish and chip supplies available. And Scarborough is actually famous for its fish and chips. Now, next on our show today, we are going to obviously do the weather, and we are going to discuss whether any of you have been to Scarborough before. Sorry about my hair. Anyways, right, in the comments below, comment box below, or on my website, you can go to therupertcoopershow.com, or on my website, you can say, have you ever been to Scarborough or a beach before? If you have, which beach was it and what did you enjoy about it the most? I am kind of tying in the Christmas special a bit in both of these episodes. So I will be doing a bit of both and a bit of Christmas stuff, even though it isn't Christmas. Can I just see if I can find my script in my drawer behind here? Hello, I found my script. And I did actually have just... a full script done for today, for the Christmas special, but unfortunately I couldn't do the Christmas special because I wasn't very well. Anyways, I will be able to do the Christmas special. I'll kind of tie it in today, kind of, and I will also do the weather. So do what I asked you and write in the comments whether you've been to Scarborough or any other seaside, and if you've been to any other seaside than Scarborough, what was it? Right, now I'm going to like start with the Christmas special. So what I would have done was, hello, welcome, my name is Rupert Cooper, da da da, yeah, and this is Merry Christmas with the Rupert Cooper Show. So coming up today, we discuss what plans you have for Christmas. We can't do that. Anyways, so what I would have done with you was a lot of things, but what I'm going to do with you today is, we are going to show you how to make a Christmas bookmark. We're going to tell you some comments that you guys have posted in about Christmas. We're going to see you what you guys got for Christmas. We're going to play Guess the App and we're going to do the weather. And that is all coming up today on the Rupert Cooper Show. Kind of special, kind of not, because I kind of was supposed to do it on Christmas, which was actually about 5 or 6 days ago.
Recording from RTV Television Studios in Batley. This is Merry Christmas with the Rupert Cooper Show. Of course, with me, Rupert Cooper.
Anyways, to start with, we are going to show you how to make a Christmas bookmark. And to show you that, here is this video of pre-recording me earlier.
Arts and crafts on the Rupert Cooper Show. With me, Rupert Cooper.
Hi guys. So, all you'll need for this video is a square 12 by 12 piece of paper. It needs to be square, that is important. That's the important part. It needs to be square. So to get started with, we need to fold this piece of paper in half
to make it look like a triangle, it needs to look like this. Then what we need to do is we need to fold both bits, both sides up like this. So, you look at the triangle like this, you're going to fold this part up here. Do the same with the other side. So then it should look a bit like this. Then what we're going to do is unfold these, and then as you'll see, you might be able to see here, we've got a little mini square creased in there. We're going to pull this thing down, sorry if you can't see, so we're going to pull the top down onto there, which is going to make a little bit like an envelope. It's going to make it like that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to pull this up again, and we are going to flip it underneath there. We're going to get this like this and flip it underneath there. So that goes under there like that. And it should just go into the middle to make it look a bit like that. So I'm going to do the same with the other side. And it should look like this. There you have your very own bookmark now. Now, it is up to you whether you want to decorate it or make it even smaller. But I'm just going to draw a smiley face on mine at the moment to look like that. So, that is how to make a Christmas bookmark, or a bookmark at least. You make the Christmas part. Now, can I just ask you guys to do me one favour? Favour. Please, can you send me in a picture of your Christmas decorated bookmarks? Because I would love to see that. Back to my future self now. Right then, so after seeing that, you will now know what to do. Sorry, Rich is just getting all cleared up. Now I'm going to tell you some of the comments that you guys have posted in to me about what. Some comments, right. Can I have a shout out for James in Bradford? Hello, James. Can I have a shout out for Louise in London? Hello, Louise. On the next show, can you play something fun? Well, I can try, but it has to be able to be played in the studio around all the camera and studio equipment. And the final one, the Rupert Cooper Show is great. Thank you for whoever it was, and I do try. Sorry, this comment doesn't make sense. Anyways, let me find that comment right. The Rupert Cooper Show is great. Thank you for starting it and making it as good as it is now. Well, thank you for whoever that was. And I do try to make it the best for all you guys watching. But you guys are the one that make it good. So thank you for watching. And anyway, next on the show, we're going to see what you guys got for Christmas and a lot more coming up on the Rupert Cooper Show. Now, I'm going to give you a look into what I got for Christmas. Now, I don't usually do this, but, sorry, I just don't want it to knock on. It's not really on at the moment, it's like kind of getting ready. I got a lava lamp for Christmas. Anyways, I did get a few more stuff, but not, I didn't get actually much. Yeah. Well, I did, but anyways, we don't need to go through what I got for Christmas, because I'm going to go through what you got for Christmas. And all the comments that I've posted in today, thank you for posting them in. You are in the prize draw that will be at the end of next year. I would have done them this year, but I can't now, because it was supposed to be at the end of the year. But I'm going to do it maybe at the end of the month this year, or maybe at the end of the year. Anyways, John from Leeds got an electric bike for Christmas. Well, that must be exciting, John, because that, well, you don't even have to pedal anymore. You can just ride and it's electric. Right, the next comment. Harry from Wakefield got a basketball net for Christmas. Now, I'm presuming, Harry, you are passionate about basketball. Well, all the best from me, and I hope you enjoy your basketball net. Jamie from Pontefract got a go-kart for Christmas. Well, well done, Jamie. Jamie. I thought we were reading somewhere else then. Well done, Jamie, and I hope you enjoy your go-kart that you got for Christmas. If you want to tell me what you got for Christmas, email me at rupcoo@yahoo.com. That is rupcoo@yahoo.com. Anyway, coming up next, let me find it. Sorry, I've also got my script on here. It's very annoying how I keep doing that. I'm not very organised because I was supposed to do a show at the start of the year, the end of the year and at the start of the year. So I was supposed to do one on the 25th of December for Christmas, the month for New Year's. But I was quite ill on the 25th, so I couldn't really do that. Anyways, what we are going to do next is we are going to play Guess the App. So, first app, it is there. Sorry. Right. This app, well done if you guessed, because it is a power mirror. Well done, guys, if you guessed that correctly. The next app is going to be up here. Well done. Well, I'll give you a few minutes to get that. Pause the video now. And posting what you think, even if it's like 4 days after I posted this, I still want to know if you guys can get it correct. Right. Well done if you got that. I'm about to give the answer. Well done if you got that. That was in short. Now this isn't really an app. It's more of a... Well, maybe, yeah. Down here. I'll give you a second to do that. And remember, pause the video and post your comment in of what you think. Right, I'm about to give you the answer. And the answer is, well done, it is YouTube. And the next one is going to be down here. Oh, and don't worry, it's not the Rupert Cooper Show. Just to let you know, you can get, you will be available to buy these on the rupertcoopershow.com very shortly. The next logo is going to be down here. This is our last logo of the day. I'll give you a minute to think about that. Oh, sorry. Well then, if you guessed it, that was Safari. Okay. Safari, yeah. It is the Apple version of Google. You can still get Google on Apple devices, though. Now, if there are any app requests that you want me to do, just post them in and I will get them done on this show for you guys. Now, last on the show tonight, today, we're going to do the weather We're going to do the weather now. Right here on the Rupert Cooper Show. But first, here's this. And welcome back. It's time for the weather on right here on the Rupert Cooper Show. So if we can go to the next slide. Sorry, I don't have the same screen on my iPad. It's kind of controlled. You can do that with a power soft mirror. You can download it on Play Store, App Store, or Galaxy Store, and you can also download it on a Microsoft laptop. You can view or show your screen onto another laptop. Let's take a look a bit closer into the Earth, not really Earth, but the world. Right, in Edinburgh, we have 2 degrees, I shall see, over here. In Belfast, 4 degrees. Over here, you will see Manchester
has 5 degrees, which is the top, so I will go through different things in a minute. Right, I'm just going to show my screen onto there now. Ah, can't really see it. Doesn't matter. Anyways, sorry. Right, in London you'll see that it's tops of 8 degrees. Brussels, it's tops of 8 degrees as well. Paris tops of 9 degrees. There's a place called Nice. Nice tops of 11 degrees. Berlin tops of 6 degrees. Warsaw tops of 5 degrees. And Riga would be tops of -1 degrees. Now that is very, very low if you ask me. Now, on the 25th, which you will know on Christmas, it is tops of 11 degrees. 26th, as you will have known because you've seen this, tops of 9 degrees. On the 27th, it will have been tops of 9 degrees again, actually. On the 28th, it will have been tops of 7 degrees. On the 29th, it will have been tops of 8 degrees. And on the 30th, tops of 8 degrees again. 31st, slight rain, but tops of 12 degrees. On the 1st, which was yesterday, it was tops of 8 degrees with sunny but cloudy. On the 2nd, which is today, tops of 6 degrees. The 3rd, which is tomorrow, it is going to be cloudy with tops of 5 degrees. The same with the 4th, tops of very cloudy with tops of 5 degrees. On the 5th, it's going to be sunny but cloudy with tops of 7 degrees. It could get to as low as -2 degrees though as well. Now, if you take a look into the closer bar chart that I will show you now. Well, that's the mouse gone. you'll see that on Sunday, it is basically what I've just gone through with you. Just the bar chart closer look into it. Now, our 30-day weather outlook is going to be December weather will be cold with increased risk of snow forecast issued. On the 3rd of the 12th, 2022, temperature below average. Precipitation below average on the 1st to the 7th. Rather cold but often dry with some clouds. Now, thank you so much for watching, and I would have wished you a Merry Christmas from us all here at RTV and Studios and the Rupert Cooper Show. But we can't do that anymore, really, because it's not Christmas and there was going to be this big thing I was going to do, and then it was going to shoot across, say Merry Christmas. It's going to shoot across, say Merry Christmas. And then it was going to shoot across, say Merry Christmas. Anyways, for people who think that this is my Christmas episode and haven't got time to watch it yet, Merry Christmas from before, and I hope you have a great new year and a great January, which is a new year. And I'm sorry that I couldn't post it yesterday. Again, thank you for watching the Rupert Cooper Show, and I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you enjoyed the bit in Scarborough. Now, just a few requests. Someone has asked me if I can give a request for a good programme to watch. Well, I did on a comment yesterday, but anyways, a good programme to watch would be Darman on YouTube.
So if you just search up Darman on YouTube and then press enter, you will see his face, which I'm just clicking on now. And his videos, he's got over 1 million subscribers. He's just got loads, and all his videos are endless. And if you just keep watching this video, it shows you just keep scrolling and scrolling and scrolling, and it just never ends. That's why Darman is so good. And once again, thank you for watching the Rupert Cooper Show with me, Rupert Cooper. Hope you have a great new year.